Topsy, the tragic symphony of an electrified soul. I. The arrival. In the dimly lit cargo hold of the steamship Sapphire Serpent, a young elephant named Topsy huddled against the cold iron bars. Her eyes, wide with fear, reflected the flickering lanterns. Born in the lush jungles of Southeast Asia, she had been stolen from her mother's side, her innocence shattered by the greed of men. The ship's captain, a grizzled man named Captain Blount, had smuggled Topsy into New York City under the guise of exotic cargo. The city's clamor assaulted her sensitive ears. The cacophony of humanity, the clatter of carriages, and the distant wail of steam whistles. Topsy's heart trembled, she missed the whispering leaves and the gentle sway of palm fronds. To the circus of deception. Topsy's arrival at the four-paw circus was both a curse and a twisted blessing. The circus touted her as the first elephant born on American soil, a lie that echoed through the sawdust-filled tents. She joined a motley crew of performing pachyderms, each with their own secrets etched into their wrinkled hides. The circus ringmaster, Mr. Barnum, paraded Topsy before the gaping crowds. She danced, trumpeted, and balanced on her hind legs, all while her heart ached for the distant jungles. But Topsy's reputation grew darker with each performance. She was labeled bad, unmanageable, and dangerous. 3. The spectators' demise. One sweltering afternoon, as the sun bore down on the circus grounds, a drunken spectator named Jesse Blount staggered into the menagerie tent. His breath reeked of cheap whiskey, and his eyes gleamed with malice. Topsy, sensing danger, backed away, her massive feet stirring the sawdust. Blount teased her, offering a bottle of whiskey. Topsy's instincts screamed. She lunged. Her trunk coiled around Blount's waist, lifting him off the ground. The crowd gasped. In that moment, Topsy's fate was sealed. Blount's lifeless body crumpled to the ground, blood staining the sawdust. For the dark bargain. The circus owners, Thompson and Dundee, saw opportunity in tragedy. They concocted a macabre plan. Topsy's execution would become a public spectacle, a grim carnival for the masses. Admission tickets were printed, and the noose was prepared. But the American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, ASPCA, intervened. They deemed hanging too cruel. Instead, they proposed a more humane method, electrocution. Topsy would be the first animal to die by electric current. V. The War of Currents. The year was 1903, and the world was embroiled in the War of Currents. Thomas Edison championed direct current, DC, while Nikola Tesla and George Westinghouse advocated for alternating current, AC. Electricity was a battleground, and Topsy stood at its epicenter. Edison, desperate to discredit Tesla's AC, saw an opportunity. He secretly funded Topsy's execution, hoping it would sway public opinion. The circus became a stage for a different kind of performance, one that would shock the world. 6. The Final Curtain. On a frigid January morning, Topsy stood in Luna Park, her massive form outlined against the gray sky. Carrots laced with cyanide were her last meal. A rope tightened around her neck, and electrodes clung to her feet. The switch was thrown, and 6,000 volts surged through her. Topsy convulsed, her eyes wide with terror. The crowd watched in morbid fascination as her massive body collapsed. Edison's cameras whirred, capturing the spectacle. The film, titled Electrocuting an Elephant, would haunt history. And so, Topsy's soul merged with the electric current, a tragic symphony of cruelty, ambition, and human folly. Her death became a footnote in the War of Currents, but her memory lingered. When the lights flicker, and the city hums with electricity, Topsy's ghost roams, a reminder that progress exacts a heavy toll.